And welcome back to Deadwood, South Dakota, the scene for round 8 of AMSOIL Championship Snocross, powered by Ram. The days of 76 rodeo grounds here, historic Deadwood, South Dakota. You see the snow falling on this great racetrack at the rodeo grounds. It's been action-packed all afternoon, and we are ready for the AMSOIL Pro Open. Let's take a look at this front row. Levi Lavalle, what do you think?
Hi, Tucker Hibbert, you know, up there in the first qualifier, shooting for that 100th win. Will he get it here tonight?
That's the front row. Now, Mike, the back row has some big names in it as well.
It sure does. Logan Christian, Justin Broberg having a problem early on. Jake Scott had engine troubles. But Dave Jonas, who last year podiumed both in the rounds that were held here in Deadwood, made it through the LCQ. He's the 15th qualifier.
15 sleds about to go racing. Let's go down to Carly Ablin, who's down with them at the starting line.
Guys, we've seen Polaris sleds first on the podium the last 3 rounds. Of course, I talked with Tim Bender earlier, who attributed that to the 5 race teams working together. That was a 6-year project in the making. This year was the year that Leighton Motorsports, that 5th team, joined the race teams and made this a way that they could find out what works and what doesn't. They're the only sled manufacturer that does it, and it seems to be working. But as we know, this is anybody's podium, guys.
That's exactly right, and thank you, Carly. And let's talk about Tucker Hibbert for just one moment here. As the snow falls, we see a bunch of fans here wearing the Tucker Hibbert gear who came here tonight to see him become Mr. 100. He's been so fast tonight. Levi Lavalle, if you had to make a prediction, would you say tonight there's a good shot this would be the night?
I think there's a very good shot. You know, he's number one qualifier. He's all the way on the inside, so all he's got to do is just get a good start. If he gets a decent start, I think it could be the night.
Mike, talk about that man standing there with his sled revving it up.
Of course, Kurt Hibbert, his dad. Of course, many records that were set as far as snowmobile racing. And I'll tell you what, the relationship that these two guys have each other, father, son, incredible. That's a big part of that team right there.
There's Tim Tremblay. Not only was he the second qualifier tonight, he's also second in points. That guy knows how to manhandle a sled around this track.
He most certainly does. You know, he's a big Canadian, and he absolutely wrestles that sled around. You'll watch him in the corners just throwing the sled. And he's been looking strong all week.
Clearing the sled out of all the cracks. And there's Cody Cam. Now let's talk about Cody Cam, Mike.
Cody Cam, your winner in round 7. You know, can he do it here in round number 8? Didn't look quite like he did in round 7, but yet still qualifying here in 5th. Anything's possible, and Cody's the kind of guy that likes to hang it out, and as Levi has said a number of times, he'll just go for it, and then he'll take and make corrections as he's making his way around the racetrack.
He's been very fast tonight, Levi.
He has been very fast. You know, he had a great run in round 7. Round 8 hasn't gone quite to plan yet, but like Mikey said, he's willing to go for it. If there's a triple out there, he's going to do it, so we'll see how that works.
They're getting fired up here on the starting line, and we are getting fired up in the booth. This is why we came to Deadwood, South Dakota. It all comes down to this. It's the Deadwood Shootout, round 8 of AMSOIL Championship Snowcross, powered by Ram, and we are about to go green. You see the guys, the last second checks of each of their sleds. 10 sleds on the front row, 5 on the back. 15 sleds about to head for turn 1 together, and it's about to go into the starter's hands. When he hits the cinch, we go green and we go racing. And we are racing at Deadwood. Tucker Hibbert to the inside. Did not get the hole shot. I believe they're probably going to get the stud boy hole shot to the 324 and Kyle Pauline as they drag race. It's Tucker off his sled.
Tucker down in the corner and Tremblay into the back of him.
Tucker did get the stud boy hole shot, but he also got collected with Tim Tremblay, the second qualifier here in turn 2, and that changes everything. Kyle Pauline is the man out front.
They got him squared away. That was a bad place for them with the traffic coming in. What a deal. Tucker getting together with Tim Tremblay.
Kyle Pauline is your leader. Let's see what happened here, Levi.
Well, you can watch off the start. You know, they all get a pretty decent jump. Kyle Pauline gets a very good jump, as well as Tucker. Tucker slots into the inside, Kyle to the outside. But as they come into that turn, you can see Tremblay Tucker actually makes a mistake by himself. Tremblay runs in the back and gets stuck with him.
Nothing Tremblay could do. Tucker was laying down in front of him. Meanwhile, out front, Kyle Poline, who won in round six at Canterbury Park, is out front again and trying to get away. It's an almost 2 second lead over Cody Cam, who's in second, and Ross the Boss Martin, who's in third. 1, 2, and 3 have been the stars of the last three races.
I want to back up 1 year ago, though, when he got together, Tucker Hibbert got together with Cody Cam. Cody was black flagged. Tucker came from the back of the field to win on this very racetrack. We're going to need to keep an eye on him.
He's got a long way to go to catch that man, though, because he was stuck at the bottom of that racetrack for a long time. Kyle Poline, very fast around the outside of this racetrack. We've got a problem again right in front of us as sleds are breaking down all over the racetrack. What a tough, tough break out here in front of us. Kyle Poline gets around him.
That was quite a thing, you know, so they had a yellow flag on an inside line. So Kyle was forced to go to the outside. They pulled the yellow just as soon as he got by. Cody Cam was able to go to the inside and make up a ton of ground on him.
Look at this. Cody Cam tries to make the move for the lead on Kyle Poline. It's the step jump, and Kyle Poline holds on to the lead for now. Doubles and doubles and the inside line for Poline. This is the battle for the lead. Kyle Poline leans low and heads down the grandstand frontaway and pulled a good line on Cody Cam as it came out of that turn, Mike.
So let's line them up. It's Kyle Poline, Cody Cam, Ross Martin sitting in third. And if we're looking where Tucker Hibbert is, he's moved up to 12.
Cam falling back quite a bit from Poline. I don't know if Poline got heavy on the gas or Cam had a bobble.
I'm not sure. It looked like Cody slowed down quite a bit. Here comes Ross coming up on him as well. But Kyle is just riding smooth right now, I think.
It looks like something might be wrong with Cody Cam. We'll check on that in a moment. Meanwhile, Kyle Poline is still your leader, and we are hearing from the booth that Cody Cam's sled has broken down. What a tough break for Cody. But let's talk about what this does for Kyle Poline. He was battling with Cody very, very hard there for quite some time. Now he's the man out there by himself.
He was. Kyle Poline out in the front. Now Ross Martin slotted into second. Logan Christian's now in third.
There's Ross Martin. He, again, as you said, your second place rider. We are right now 7 laps into a 22 lap feature, and Ross Martin is in second place, Mike.
And it's been a while since we've seen Logan Christian on the podium. Right now sitting in third place, and he's about four and a half seconds ahead of Justin Broberg, who's in fourth place. And let's keep an eye on the number 68 sled. Tucker Hibbert now in ninth place.
That 43 sled, that's Logan Christian. As we said, he's your man in third spot right now, the man on the bubble for the AMSOIL pedestal, I should say. Logan Christian, the 43 right there over the step-up jump. Meanwhile, out front, Kyle Poline, the 324 is your leader, looking for his second win on the season. And my goodness, does he look fast right now,
Levi. He looks extremely well. You know, Kyle's turning in some great laps. You know, he's pulling a little bit on Ross. Ross slightly faster that last lap. So, you know, Ross is definitely charging up. He wants that win, but Kyle is doing everything he can to stay out front.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you, I got to agree with you. It looked like Ross may have been reeling him in a little bit on that lap. There you go. That's Kyle Poline, your leader. A little rough into that turn right there. We'll see Ross Martin into the screen right now. That's second place. That's the 837 of Ross Martin, who came into this race actually very, very fast, but has had a rough day all day today. Right now, he's reeling in Kyle Poline. Both your first and second place racers on the screen.
Ross Martin now about 2.4 seconds behind Kyle Poline. And as you said, they've been running just about ideal lap time. So, you know, Ross not able to make up any ground on your leader right there, Kyle Poline. You know, we remember the last race that Kyle won, his first pro win at Canterbury, he went flag to flag. It's like when he gets out front, he is driven, and Kyle running a good race right now.
He
over
is
the
running.
Step-up jump.
He's running a great race, but I think Ross is just reeling them slow and surely. About 2/10 a lap, he's been faster than him. So if he keeps that up, they're going to be battling tight really close.
Meanwhile, there's Tucker Hibbert. The T-Train has moved himself into fifth place after total destruction on the first lap. Let's go down to Carly Applin, who's right beside the racetrack. Carly?
Tony Swantek, a mechanic for Ross Martin. Tell us what you're seeing out there. How is Ross's race going in second right now? And what was the conversations like with him before the race?
Well, the conversation was we knew the track was going to deteriorate. Had to just kind of be cautious and bide our time. And he's in second now, gaining on the lead. So
We'll let you get back to it, okay? Thank you so much. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Carly. Over the AMSOIL finish line right there was Ross Martin, but he is running out of laps. We are now 14 laps out of 22 in this feature. The lead for Kyle Poline, right there, your leader, is 1.4 seconds. So it continues to get a little bit smaller as Kyle Poline hits lap traffic. There's your second place racer on the left side of your screen as we see Darren Mees, a little bit of lap traffic right there. Over the AMSOIL finish line goes your leader.
You see your leader. He comes across. Martin has made up some ground right behind him. And there you see, of course, some lappers that they've gotten around. Logan Christian sitting in third, but now Tucker up into fourth place. Just one position off the podium. And there you see T-Train right there.
Tucker must be just driving out of his mind. Not only was he in last, but he was well in last after a crash on the first lap. Right now, he's battling for third. The 43 sled is Logan Christian. He's in third. Tucker Hibbert, the 68 right now, is in fourth. Has come all the way back from the back of the pack to compete for a podium. And I'll tell you, he is not done yet. He was off his sled. Now he's just off the podium. Meanwhile, up front, we have a battle for the lead. Ross Martin into Kyle Poline, Levi.
You can see they got into each other a little bit there. Kyle still snuck out ahead, but Ross is charging hard. He's got a couple smooth lines, and he's using them. If Kyle doesn't pick it up, he's gonna lose his first place position.
You know, these two guys have raced each other many, many, many times, and usually it's real clean. I mean, these guys are giving it a little contact there, but I'll tell you what, Martin right now gets around.
We have a new leader, Ross Martin, but Kyle comes to the inside, can't get it back. Ross, the boss Martin, has taken the lead in Deadwood.
And not only has Martin taken the lead, but Hibbert is on the podium. Hibbert sitting in third place, and if you look right now, he is only 3.8 seconds out of the lead.
You can see Ross Martin, he's got a lower jump off that first double-double. Kyle skied it, and Ross just doubled right by him.
There is your leader and your second place rider. Your new leader is Ross the Boss Martin out of Burlington, Wisconsin for AMSOIL and Polaris. We are now to lap 19. There's Tucker Hibbert to the inside of Kyle Poline. It's Poline and Hibbert. Ross Martin just in front of him. And Tucker Hibbert, the T-Train, is on a rail. He's moved up to second. He's already got Ross Martin in his sights. Martin dealing with lap traffic. Tucker to the outside. It's a drag race in front of the grandstands here in Deadwood. Over the AMSOIL finish line. Tucker right on Ross Martin's tail. 20 laps into this race, two to go. Ross Martin just ahead of Tucker Hibbert. Can he get it done?
Tucker Hibbert's got a great line on this backstretch. What he does is he's working the outside, and he's able to triple into this section. Right here is where it's coming. Watch this. Right
Tucker there. Hibbert to the outside. It's a drag race, and Tucker Hibbert has taken the lead in pursuit of 100 wins. One lap away from 100 wins is Tucker Hibbert.
You know what? If you're going to take and have 100 wins, why not make it exciting? He is doing it right here.
Less than half a lap from 100 wins is the T-Train. Tucker Hibbert into the final turns for the final time. And down the stretch he comes. Tucker Hibbert, the number 68 sled across the AMSOIL finish line, has done it. 100 feature wins for the first time in the history of AMSOIL Championship Snowcross. What a way to win 100 races, from dead last and off his sled to the championship and the win. Tucker Hibbert has done it here in Deadwood. And that is an excited individual right there. We have just seen history. We'll come right back and talk to your winner, but before we do, let's celebrate Tucker Hibbert's 100 victories. There you see it. The celebration has begun in earnest. 100 feature wins for Tucker Hibbert, and he does it here in Deadwood tonight. Levi Lavallee, any way to put that into words?
It's incredible. I mean, to win 100 races, to tip over in the first turn and be it nearly a lap down to come back and win, that was an incredible, incredible race.
I got to be honest with you, Mike Schroeder. I rode him off after crashing on that first lap.
Not me. I'll tell you what. When you watched him and you've seen what he's done here before, you know, there was no doubt that as driven and as strong as he's been on this racetrack today, that there was the potential for him to get back up front. He drove his heart out. You see him with his dad, Kurt, on the back. Iceman's given him both the checkered flags, and very deserving of that 100 wins.
We have just seen history. I'll say it again. In historic Deadwood, South Dakota. What a great shot. And again, what a great way to win that race. He'd been the fastest all day. And then suddenly, everything went wrong in turns 1 and 2 on the very first lap of this race.
You know, I was in a lot of trailers today, and you know what everybody said? Everybody said, I'll tell you what. Did you see Tucker in his first practice? And I said, no. They said, he's out for it. I mean, they said that he is just incredible. So, just wild.
All the team congratulating him.
Russ Ebert there from
Arnie
Camp.
There you go, Tucker. Great win, man. What a way to do it.
Tom Rager from Polaris congratulating him. A lot of the other folks. Man, I'll tell you what. These are the kind of moments you soak in.
The crowd just going crazy for Tucker Hibbert. Everybody from every team congratulating him on 100 wins.
There's Kyle Pelline's dad congratulating him.
So Tucker was your winner. Ross Martin did finish second, and Kyle Pelline came in third. Logan Christian came in fourth. Justin Broberg in fifth. Tim Tremblay holds on for sixth. Jake Scott in seventh. Andy Leaders in eighth. David Jonas in ninth. And Corin Todd rounds out your top 10. Again, Tucker Hibbert getting his helmet off, and we'll be not only presenting him with his trophy for tonight's win, but congratulating him on 100 victories. And we are racing in Deadwood. Tucker Hibbert to the inside. Did not get the whole shot. 324 and Kyle Pelline as they drag race. It's Tucker off the sled.
Able to triple into this section. Right here is where it's coming. Watch this. Right
Tucker there. Hibbert to the outside. It's a drag race. And Tucker Hibbert has taken the lead. And down the stretch he comes. Tucker Hibbert, the number 68 sled across the AMSOIL finish line, has done it. 100 feature wins for the first time in the history of AMSOIL Championship Snowcross.
Congratulations, Tucker Hibbert. 100 pro national wins tonight, and to do it with a crash in that first lap. How does this moment feel?
It feels amazing. You know, I don't know what it is with Deadwood, but it fires me up on day two, I guess. But 100 wins is amazing, you know. It's a lot of races, and I'm thankful for every single one of them, the wins and the losses, you know. These guys standing behind me, my team, been behind me 100%. Can't thank them enough. Got to thank God for giving me the talent. I'm just trying to do the best I can with it, and it was a gnarly race. I found some good lines and just kept hammering down, you know. I had no idea. I didn't have time to look at my pit board. I didn't know where I was. I just wanted to pass every single sled as fast as I could, and I got across the finish line and saw the flames, so that was a good feeling for sure. You know, I just got to thank the whole team, Monster Energy, Arctic Cat, Ram Truck, Speedworks, everyone that's behind me my whole career. I appreciate it. Thank you.
And in the last three races, you were held off at 99 by some of your other racers. You know, did that give you some extra motivation? Did you make any changes going into this race after those?
I didn't make any changes, but yeah, it definitely motivated me. You know, that 100 was making me work hard, and these guys are pushing me. Every race, everyone's getting a little bit better, and I'm having to find ways to do the same. One thing that helped was my mom. She made me a bag of 100 cookies for my 100 wins. I really wanted to eat those things tonight, so got to thank her.
Well, again, congratulations. We are going to present you with the 100th Pro National Win Trophy. John Daniels is going to be joining us from ISOC to present you with this trophy. John, what would you like to say to Tucker?
I don't think I've ever seen anything quite so awesome, Tucker. This is the greatest race I think I've ever seen. Last night, I thought that was the best race I've ever seen, but this tops it, man. It was unbelievable. And this crowd in Deadwood got a hell of a run, didn't they? Good job, buddy.
And what would you like to say one more time to your teammates and to the fans?
Oh, I just got to thank everybody again for supporting me for so long, and all the competitors for pushing me to be where I am. Without them, I wouldn't be up here. And got to thank John and everyone from ISOC for putting on such a great series for us to race in and giving us an opportunity to come out here and stand on the podium. And, I'm so happy. It's a good feeling. It's a relief for me. Just focus on the rest of the season now and just hammer down.
Again, congratulations. Now we're going to let them celebrate and head back to you guys in the booth.
Well, there you have it, and quite an honor to call the 100th feature win for Tucker Hibbert. As the celebration begins down there in AMSOIL Championship Snocross near the finish line there, let's look at how they finished, by the way. Tucker Hibbert, of course, the winner, but we talked about it. Ross Martin comes across in second to hold onto the podium, and Kyle Pelin, a very strong third, Levi.
Yeah, Ross was able to move past Kyle Pelin in that race and, looked really strong. Logan Christian was able to hang on for fourth. Tim Tremblate was able to get sixth after being tangled up with Tucker, so he had a heck of a ride, too.
Mike, you've seen a lot of wins from Tucker Hibbert. 100, what's it mean?
Well, 100's huge. There's no doubt about it. And I've seen a lot of him. I've seen him set a number of milestones when he broke Blair Morgan's record. And, of course, as he moved through up into the 80s and the 90s and now the 100. But I think the biggest thing is the fact of the way he accomplished it here tonight. Last year he did the same thing. He got in an altercation with Cody Cam, was in last place, went on to win. And like he said, I think that the talent and the quality and the skill of the drivers has really pushed him to be what he is. I really do. And so congratulations going out to Tucker and, of course, Kurt and the whole team down there just doing a great job.
It's time to hand out some hardware, Mike. Let's give it to him, huh?
You bet. Let's give you the top three here in the AMSOIL Pro Open Final. In third place, out of Ironwood, Michigan, racing for Mystic Lubricants. Also racing for Polaris, Fox, FXR, and Earth Inc. On the 324 Polaris, third place, Kyle Pelin. Smile still there, Levi. Don't need to work on that. In second place, out of Burlington, Wisconsin, racing for AMSOIL, Exalted, Jack Links, Beef Jerky, Clem, and of course, SSI decal. On the number 837 Polaris, second place, Ross Martin. And taking the win out of Pelican Rapids, Minnesota, racing for Monster Energy, Artie Cat, Ram Truck, Artie Quare, Stud Boy, and Fly. It is my honor and my privilege to invite him to the podium for the 100th professional win. First place tonight, Tucker Hibbert. Let's send it down to Winner's Circle and Carly Haplin. Carly?
I can't beat the smiles that are down here right now. Kyle Pelin, congratulations. Tell fans what the intensity was like out there on the track, because watching it was extremely intense.
Oh, it's so crazy. The track got so chewed up and just so rough. Like, I had so many close calls to coming off, and it was just intense the entire race. I never was like, oh man, this is just like, a joyride. It was just bar to bar, wide open the entire time.
And who would you like to thank tonight?
I got to give a huge thanks to my sponsors, Mystic Lubricants, Loctite, Polaris, Fox Shocks, FXR, Earth Inc., and Woody Studs. And just huge, huge thanks to my team. They put in countless hours. My mechanic, Jeff, Glenn Kafka, he's a clutch guru and ripped me that whole shot. So big hats off to him and my family and the dear Lord for giving me this ability to be out here and do what I love. So, and of course, all the fans. So you guys are awesome.
Again, congratulations, and congratulations to Ross Martin back up here on the podium. We love to see that. Talk about the pass you made on Kyle Pelline, and then when Tucker Hibbert made a pass on you.
Yeah, it was definitely a crazy race. It was one of them races. It was just so hard to see anything, and coming in the lapper so quick, it was hard to see what was going on. I think I went over the finish line blind a couple times, but no, they rode great, and I'm super pumped to be up here.
And who would you like to thank?
I got to thank my team, all my sponsors, Exalta, Jack Lynx, AMSOIL, Polaris, Rockstar, Fly Racing, Walker Evans, everyone that got me here. Thanks a lot, guys.
Congratulations. And Tucker Hibbert, again, a huge congratulations on your 100 Pro National wins. How does it feel to be up here tonight? A little extra special and a little deja vu, maybe.
Yeah, this race has been gnarly for me the last couple years. And, you know, I was fired up the last couple races. I haven't been able to get on top and, you know, just really motivated tonight to get up here. And I pulled the whole shot, which I was so relieved to get out front right away. And then in the second turn down here, I just totally blew the whole race almost. I hit a big snow wall and tipped over and collected Tim Tremblay. And we were stuck there for so long, I figured the whole race was over. And I just kept charging and charging. I found some really, really good lines. I had no idea. I didn't know I won. I just wanted to pass everyone I could possibly pass, and it was so gnarly right to the finish. And, you know, I'm really thankful to be up here, and got to give it up to my team, Monster Energy, Arctic Cat, Ram Truck, and my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for blessing me and keeping me safe tonight.
Congratulations. A huge weekend in Deadwood. We're going to celebrate down here and head back to you guys in the booth.
Carly, great job all weekend long, and great job to our podium finishers. And again, congratulations, Tucker. What a show you put on for us tonight. I think it's fascinating, guys, that he didn't even know he won until he saw the flames in the air. Right? That's fascinating.
Well,
man.
And that's focus, too. Yeah. I mean, you know, that's just crazy. I mean, I'll tell you what, not only being part of history tonight, but tell you what, Deadwood had seen some awesome racing this weekend. I had fun. How about you, Levi?
Yeah, it was some great racing, you know, to see Tucker go from all the way from the back, worked through the whole pack, didn't even know he won the race. And, I mean, that was a pretty special win for him.
Well, guys, as we go out, we'll look at the Tucker 100 victory video one more time before we retire from here. But we leave here. We go all the way across the country to New York next week for the next round of racing here on AMSOIL Championship Snowcross, powered by Ram. If we get out of Deadwood with all this snow coming down, thanks, everybody, for tuning in. For Mike Schroeder, Carly Applin, Levi Lavalle, my name is Chris Hockey, and once again, you've just witnessed history thanks to Tucker Hibbert. Let's take a look at those 100 victories one more time.